Operating as a non-profit has its own challenges in South Africa because you are competing against 100,000 NGOs, and I was busy studying my social entrepreneurship certification at business school at Gibbs, and I kept thinking, what was our sustainability angle for this business? Because we had a foundation that was donating pads to girls, but what are we trying to teach girls? And for me as a businesswoman, I learned that financial literacy was one of my biggest challenges, and I thought as a sustainability arm, it'd be interesting to bring girls out of poverty into grassroots levels, into an environment that teaches them personal development, confidence, coaching, entrepreneurial skills, and anything that will give them the credibility to move into a job spec or something where that gives them full-time employment.
Hi, my name is Ayana Dimani, I'm 21 years old.
My name is Dina Manara and I'm 18 years of age.
I am Zipelele from Soweto.
My name is Sinisila Fani, I'm 24 years old.
What I'm expecting to gain from the experience is self-confidence, entrepreneur skills and communication skills.
What happy days mean to me is to be free, happy and live a life.
The happy days means a lot to me because it teaches people how to be dependent on themselves, be confident, ambitious and reliable.
My target sales for the next few months is to sell at least 300 packs of sanitary towels.
My target for the sales is that I am going to sell 25,000 pads within 3 months.
The inspiration behind Pads and Sense was women empowerment. It's my biggest core passion in life is that as a brown skin girl, you can do anything that you need to do. And for me, Pads and Sense was giving women the opportunity with something that we created to go out there and create change amongst themselves, which was removing them from things that make them vulnerable through poverty, which is financial stability, because they earn a 20% commission on whatever they sell in this business, which is theirs and theirs alone. It exposes them to a world of business that's been created via my network as a woman business entrepreneur of sort. But it's also, I think, the inspiration is to give them the ability and the permission to say you can do it, because there's a big pink circle that backs you. I think Pads and Sense it's a stepping stone to saying, I belong to this business, I've become a brand ambassador, I've learned all these lessons in coaching and entrepreneurship and school fees, and I'm capable of saying I want to have my own empire one day or my own business model. But it's a pure focus on women leadership, women entrepreneurship. What the idea was that we'll teach girls how to become direct sales agents of our business with the skill sets of facilitators from NCARE that will later translate into them moving from how I'm so shy to do this and not ask for a job into exiting the incubator to becoming a brand ambassador in their community or their township, and eventually moving into a business arena or a corporate job facility. That was the vision 2 years ago. It came live with a partner like SAB Miller in May this year. We're halfway through the incubator. And Pads and Sense was basically teaching you financial literacy on saving, securing, investing in your future as a woman leader, and believing in yourself that you can do whatever you can with whatever you have, with the right mentorship and coaching.
The skills that the young ladies have learned have been a combination of cognitive and non-cognitive skills, where the cognitive skills had to do with business development, sales, communication. And then on the non-cognitive side, they've had to learn leadership development as it relates to grit and similar skills.
The program is targeted at women because women in society are marginalized to a certain extent. This program's significance is that it enables them to play a bigger role within the economy, and that it gives them the confidence and the key skills to help them navigate within the economy.
Lebitso la ka ke Karabo ne. Ke nna ona mo mokasi mo Kalfontein. Ke motho lo reng ke ambassador ya Happy Days mo lo reng e dila ka basadi fela youth. Mo Happy Days ba creator di pets tsa Happy Days. Se lo reng hangata re tsama ka tsona e lo re ra di donate mo dikolong tse lo ra bana hore ba di tshoka. Ntse lo re fela re tsama re ya mo dikolong. And then here mo dikolo mo ro ira research pele re hutse gore dikolo tse di tshwere bana ba mohuta mang ba safara bokanang kang, cause like mo Kalfontein mo ha ona di bana ba teng ka bongata ba safara ke la bona. So like ntse re lemogileng ko gore bana ba bangata ba face di problem tsa gore a ba nna le boabuti ba bona, and then ba bang o tlo thola e le gore a ba na financially gore o tlo kry-a e le gore a ba na selo ke la bona. So ra bona e le gore ba bangwe ba re botsa gore he re ira di-research o tlo kry-a le ko sekolong ba koleka di-2 rand ba fa di-teacher for gore ba kgone go fiwa di-pets only to find out gore di-pets tsa ba di kry-ang o tlo kry-a ba kry-a just one such tšhelete ele ya teng.
So, fan mona yam. So taking sa. I'm a lady peg swam. Then ke ngoku siphinde siwathengise just for ba sikwazi ukuqhubeleka siyikhampani siwenze yibona 10 rand iphakethe le 1 pay.
To me, it feels great because now I'm more empowered, I'm more confident, and I'm ready to conquer the world.
It means a lot to me because my dreams are coming true. Everything that I'm going to pursue is coming true because, like, I have information of how to be an entrepreneur, and also I know what I'm going to do when I'm going to pitch to the different investors.
It means a lot to me. Now I have I can knock to the door that now I've never knocked to through to the experience that I've got, and I'm really proud of it.
I am super excited
this program has been exciting from the beginning till now. Being a graduate under this category of being a businesswoman, it's really exciting. Through this program, I learned so much. I learned so much, so many skills. I learned how to be confident in my own skin, in my own space. I've learned a lot about business and mentoring other youth.
The skills that I've got here, the communication skills.
The communication skills.
PR skills, sales skills, also the communications one. Most importantly, the self-confident one.
I'm going to apply these skills when I'm going to pitch on my incubators or investors.
How am I planning to implement those skills in the business that I'm about to embark on, also the future clients that I'll be meeting with?
I can communicate with different people as I'm selling pets.
With the skills I've learned from Happy Days, I am looking forward to using them in the future. There's so many plans that I'm having for the future.
Highlights of the program is to meet with the different ministers in terms of pitching about program, and also the CEO of different companies. For example, I went to Northern Cape. I met with the district municipalities there, whereby we were going to give pets to the young girls in Northwest. And also I met with the CEO of the SA Express, whereby we were empowering the young women in South Africa.
The highlight of the program is when I was meeting new people in this program, different people from different places. It means a lot to me, even to stand in front of them, presenting myself. It was really like, wow. So I'm really grateful.
The best highlight for me is when I was at the Midlands on the youth event that I was. That's where I did my first PR speech. I remember I was in tears. The wall was full of lots of people. So yeah, that was my greatest highlight.
Highlights from this program are the teamwork games that we played, and it taught us how to be one as a team and how to learn from others. And our other highlights were brainstorming with our mentor, our CEO, Ramon Casavan. That was played an impact in our lives.
My vision for Pads and Sense for South Africa alone is that we would have this incubator live in 9 provinces next year, which is 2017, meaning that we'd have 100 ambassadors building more businesses, having more help in an inclusive economy. But the sky's the limit where my thinking is concerned. I really think this is something that can be replicated throughout Africa. I mean, SADC has 15 countries. We could implement them there, but I think that every woman needs to understand that I do have a fair opportunity. It's only their own mindsets and barriers that remove them from actually going out there and pursuing it. And it's like Pads and Sense is basically that expensive ticket you pay to go to a coaching session with a global speaker, but it's all done in a room, step by step, hand holding to see what level you can get to. And I think that everyone deserves a fair shot at that, especially women, because a lot of us have our own families that limit us. And for me, it's the vision of empowering women continentally to believe that I can be a global leader, I can be a visionary, I can be a leader in my own community, I can create social change, I can be, it's just basically I can. So I think that our expansion will be the rest of South Africa and then the rest of the continent with our financial partners and some of our distribution partners. The sky is the limit. So happy days every day.